In the last video, reading from and writing to a Modbus leaf coil was done by the Modbus Master PLC. Today, we will consider reading from analog and digital inputs of a Modbus leaf. The MF2 is the Modbus function number 2 for reading digital input data from a Modbus leaf. The MF2 instruction is similar to MF1, but the variable read is different. The offset starting from 0 to 127 corresponds to S.1 to S.128 contact variables in the Modbus leaf. The retrieve value will be indicated on arrow.1. Choose Nano V5 from the settings menu and the Nano port number. You don't need to set the baud rate and Modbus address for a Modbus master. For the slave PLC, delete wrong 0. Change the contact variable to S.1. Set the baud rate and the Modbus address to be the same as the MF2 instruction of the master PLC. Then upload the code to the slave PLC Nano. The circuits from the last video should be modified to include a potentiometer at A.1 analog input of the slave PLC. The push button switch connection is removed from S.1 of the master PLC to S.1 input of the slave PLC. Before connecting the TX and RX pins, hold down the push button switch. Observe that the indicator lamp on the slave PLC is turned on. Release the switch and connect the TX and RX pins. Hold down the push button switch and observe that both indicator lamps in the master and the slave PLCs are turned on. MF4 is the Modbus function number 4 for reading analog data from a Modbus slave. The offset from 0 to 25 corresponds to A.1 to A.26 in the slave PLC. The retrieved data is stored in an integer variable I.1 of the master PLC. The analog input value ranging from 0 to 1023 in I.1 is scaled to between 0 and 100. The result is then stored in I.2. A greater than instruction make arrow.1 coil true when I.2 is greater than 50. For the slave PLC, delete MF4 and the greater than instruction. Insert an analog and a less than instructions in their place. Arrow.1 will be true when I.2 is less than 50. Before connecting the communication ports of the Nanos, observe that the indicator lamp of the slave PLC is off. When the potentiometer is being adjusted to the other end, the lamp is turned on. Connect the TX and RX pins. As the potentiometer is adjusted from one end to the other, the on and off state of the indicator lamps of both the master and slave PLCs are inverted. Thanks for watching. Reading from and writing to a holding register will be considered in the next video. Please click on the like button if this video is helpful. See you again soon.